Hi there. Welcome to the Stock Scores Market Minutes for March 14th, 2016. This week, my topic is the risk-reward trade-off. Let's talk a little bit about what I mean. As a trader, assuming you use stops, and I recommend that you do, you want to limit your downside when you're wrong. If you have a tighter stop, which means the stop loss price is closer to your entry price, then you can have a larger position. So if you're buying a stock at $10 and your stop is at $9, you've got a dollar per share in risk. If you tighten your stop, move it up to $9.50, well, now you've only got 50 cents a share in risk. And so in theory, you can buy twice as many shares, assuming you have enough capital to do that. However, when you tighten your stop, of course, you also lower your probability of success. With a tighter stop, you have a greater chance of being stopped out before the stock ultimately makes its move. So what is better, having that tight stop or a wider stop? Well, to answer that question, you need to understand the probability of success under each stop scenario. So what is better? If you have a 70% chance of making $3 for every $1 risked, or with a tighter stop, you have a 50% chance of making $6 for every $1 risked, what's better? Well, let's just look at the math. So if you have a 70% chance of making $3, you have an expected value, not factoring in the loss, of $2.10. If you have a 50% chance of making $6, then you have actually a higher expected value because, of course, the loss is the same. You're losing potentially $1 a share or $1, you know, the example here, $3 profit for every $1 risk. So even though your success rate is quite a bit lower at 50%, you've actually increased the expected value of the trade because you've got the tighter stop. Therefore, you buy more shares and therefore your total profit can be greater. Now, that's not always the case. You need to find that critical point where the tighter stop stops being valuable to your trading strategy. You need to understand the ideal reward for risk trade-off for whatever trading strategy you're doing, whether it's day trading, swing trading, or position trading. All right, let's move into this week's analysis. Here is the 30-day, 60-minute chart. Very important chart because if we were to draw a trend line like this, that was really the trend line on the daily. If you were to look at a daily time frame going back much longer, you would see that that was the trend line. And on the open Thursday, we had news of what the ECB was doing in terms of its stimulus, and that caused that gap up. However, the sellers came in and defended that trend line of resistance, and price moved down below the trend line, and then actually came just above it to close above it that day. And that was actually a signal to buy the market. Well, the following day, we had the gap up on Friday, and we continued to rise all day Friday. So although this stock chart looks a little bit overbought because we've been going up for quite some time, it is still a bullish chart. We have a nice upward trend. I would exercise a little bit of caution because it is been going up for a little while, but we certainly recharge buyer interest with this little pullback that happened leading into the ECB decision. Now, of course, next week we have the decision from the US Federal Reserve, and that'll be critical to determine whether the longer term trend for stocks can be broken. Now, this is the 3-year weekly chart, and this trend line, which I've drawn many times, kind of looks like that. I maybe drew it a little bit too tight, maybe more like this, with resistance at around the 205 level. So we could move up next week and hit that 205 level and get stuck and then roll over and start to move lower again. I think that is what will probably happen. I think we've got some more upside potential short term, but not a lot of upside potential. So it's more of a day or swing trader's upside, but not an investor's upside. The market was very oversold here. It has come back up to the resistance. It's almost there. It's got a little more upside, maybe $2 or $3 on the SPY before it gets stuck. And then we'll see if it can break through. On the balance of probability, probably doesn't break through that level. So we got to keep a close eye on it. Short term, the next few days, probably some strength ahead. But looking out a week or two, I think you want to be careful. Similar situation on the Russell 2000, of course, the US small caps. You've got a downward trend line there. We were oversold, ran away from the trend line. Now we're coming back to the trend line. One of the basic rules of chart analysis. So we've got a little more upside there. We're looking at, we're roughly around 108 now. We're probably going to peak around the 111, 112 points, you've got 2-3% of upside before we're going to see some resistance. 2-3% upside is good if you're a swing trader, but as an investor, to be buying these stocks for long term right now, I think is a risky venture. I'd like to see that downward trend line get broken first. Now, the US market, or pardon me, the Canadian market is in this very well-defined linear upward trend, mostly because there's just generally some strong buying coming into the oil and gas stocks, which are heavily oversold. We're in a very tight upward sloping channel and no sign of a break of that channel. We had a little tease there when oil prices had some trouble on Thursday. But of course, all prices popped up again Friday, and so we continue to be in that upward sloping channel. All right, moving along. Wrong chart. There's the TSX Venture Market, and we talked about this last week. We had a downward trend that was broken a few weeks ago. Now we're in a nice little upward move there, mostly because the TSX Venture has a heavy weighting of mining and energy stocks, the junior ones. And therefore, it has been moving up with the bounce back in oil and in gold. I don't know that that continues short term. I think we probably are a little overbought here and due for a bit of a pullback. But I like how this chart is shaping up, because at least we have broken that trend. What I'd like to see is build of a rising bottom and then break from that rising bottom. That would be a better indication that this market is in fact turning around. On the treasuries, you can see we had some weakness this week, and that's mostly because the stock market stabilized. It was able to break that downward trend line on the daily, and so money comes out of the safety of bonds and starts to look for some risk again. I wouldn't count this little upward bias out. I think we could see a little more downside, bounce off of that trend line, and then perhaps start to move up again. So short term, look for treasuries to go down, but longer term, don't be surprised if we retest some of those highs. US dollar. We're in a little bit of a pennant pattern right now. You can see that we've been building that pennant for some time. Yes, we had a down week this week that was supportive for particularly oil, but we haven't really broken out of this pattern. Until we get a break one way or the other, I wouldn't get too excited about what's going on with the US dollar. Yeah, it was down a little this week, but week before was up a little. It's not really giving us a strong message of where it wants to go next. Gold. I think gold is a bit overbought. I've talked about this for some time, but this Friday here, we actually saw gold roll over. And looking, if you were to look at an intraday, say a 30-minute chart going back a couple of weeks, you would see that gold broke down late on Friday. I was bearish on gold last week. And some conversations I had on a radio show, I felt like gold was overbought and due for a pullback. It didn't really happen for most of the week until Friday, when the weakness started to really come in. And if you've been following me on Twitter, you'll know that I talked a little bit about that impending weakness on gold. I think gold probably goes lower. Not to say that it looks ugly. I just think short term, it's overbought. Here's our trend line. We need to pull back to that trend line, because we got a little emotional here, a little emotional there, and the emotion needs to come out of the market. On the oil chart, talked about this last week, the long-term downward trend line was broken. And so that is a good signal that a bottom has been made. It's not an ideal signal. We want to see a rising bottom and then a break from a rising bottom. But I do think that there is a 65% chance that oil has made its bottom here. And that probability will increase if we can see a little bit of a pullback short term, formation of a rising bottom, and then a break from that. That may take a few weeks to unfold, but certainly I'm feeling better about oil, but still I don't think you want to be all in on the oil stocks, because there is a lot of risk there. In terms of fear in the market, we've had a rollover of fear with the ECB defending the market with their stimulative action, and so we saw the VIX move lower. Wouldn't surprise me if the VIX moves down into here. That would coincide with a little bit more of a rally in stocks short term, but when they get to that resistance level at the long-term weekly downward trend line, that's where the VIX may bounce again, and so I think we still may be able to play this one for a little bit of fun and excitement. So my outlook then, U.S. stocks long-term, I am neutral. It's just I don't see a lot of upside until we hit that weekly downward trend line. But short-term, hey, the trend is up. Let's be bullish short-term if you are a trader. Canadian stocks, similar situation. They're in a great upward trend short-term, but they still have a lot of pessimism to chew through. And we're seeing a lot of overbought situations in some of the key sectors in Canada. Gold, neutral long-term. it's broken the downward trend line to some extent, but short term, I think it could roll over here and see some profit taking in the next week or two. Oil, I'm actually bullish long term because that downward trend line has been broken. Not overly bullish. As I said, 65% chance it has made the lows, but neutral short term just because I think it is overbought and due for a little bit of a pullback. Maybe not Monday, but sometime soon. So stocks have broken the downward trend line, but appear overbought. Upside to the longer term downward trend line, that's the one on the weekly, is not substantial. Gold appears to be ready for some profit taking. It started to show signs of that on Friday. Oil showing signs it has made that long-term bottom, but it is overbought in the short term and therefore expect a pullback. Less fear, therefore we can be a little bit more stock specific in our trading. But still, be cautious. There's lots of risk factors out there. Well, that has been the Stock Scores Market Minutes. Make sure you follow me on Twitter. Make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel. Have a great week in the market and trade well.